Right, okay, so the next part of the video, Teotl 1. And so yeah, I'm sorry by the way that my keyboard and mouse noises are sort of prominent in the background of this video, because I'm putting the phone on the table, on the desk in front of the keyboard. It's either that or put the phone in my lap, and I think that would cause my voice to start, you know, fading when as I move my legs. So yeah, but no, that apart from that, so we just finished Oztoc II, where we met an ancient king, as he's called in the campaign text. There is ancient king. So the golden entrance. Yes, he made us think he was kidding us when he dropped us into water, but then when we were in the water, it turned out we had a golden entrance to open. So let's go on and see what's in store. Two rivers. Okay, I think. Yes, we start underwater. And as I say, we're saying goodbye to the menu music now. Instead, we're hearing new music known as the Eternal Moon, which is music that I happen to like. Now, I should say as well, I have... Oh, sorry.
With their guidance, mankind built the cities of Teotl. Deep inside the violent mountain, safe from the furies of the netherworld. Until the caretakers wrought the plague. And so mankind fled back into the daylight, and left them buried. They must never get out.
Birds. Yeah, how have those birds survived so long? Oh god, yes, all the graffiti. See, the remains of a devastated society. So, what was I saying? Oh yes, I have managed to get every single secret in Teotl before. So you won't have any faffing around in this video unless I've forgotten something, which I don't think I have. But yeah, I'd say one of them's around here, isn't it? Oh, I think I'm going wrong already. Oh yeah, it's down there. And as well as that, it's pronounced, I'm not sure how it's pronounced, it's something like Teotl. It's certainly not Teotl, anyway. Just to clear that up. But the plague, yes, there was a plague. And they're kind of vague on that in the story, but the secrets will tell us what it's about. Hopefully. Now. Chantico. Adversity is a patient trait. Owning our influence is much like gouging the iotl from its shell. We learned that beasts are changed by the gift as well as man. See? Not even lesser nations, beasts do. First, the worms in the soil beneath the Teocalli doubled in length. Then the monkeys wielded spears and turned on each other. The apes swam to their deaths. We must have the patience. Beasts cannot. Yeah. Well, the monkeys seem fairly pacifist when we actually see them here, but yeah, we can just keep on going and find out what's really going on. Anyway, this place is awesome. Oh yes, Teotl. Sorry, almost forgot. Teotl means awesome or god. So yeah, the logical level naming. Well, the place is looks kind of awesome. All the waterfalls, huge cavern, even the ominous birds, and yeah, it's also the name of the game studio, Awesome or God. They obviously nothing wrong with their egos, and that's the symbol of the so-called caretakers, the aliens, and loads of graffiti over it. So people started, the plague made people rebel. Well, people rebelled, and that's what caused the plague to happen. And then the plague caused people to do this. This graffiti on the wall. Okay. That's supposed to be the ball, is it? I think. Or is it the sun? The one of the same down here, kind of. Okay. So, yeah, we're supposed to knock this thing down, even though there's skulls on it. Clearly, it's not going to end well. Broke the crystal. See, breaking crystals and this sort of mystical crystal is never a good idea. Mummies are built into the puzzle. That's very weird. Okay, so how do I proceed? Like a yin yang symbol over there, kind of. It's also kind of like one of the symbols for the Combine in Half-Life 2. Yes, the king that we saw in the last level, he was both Combine and G-Man. Cool. If we continue the Half-Life references. Well, gotta have Half-Life references. Considering what an influential game it's been and all that. Ignore that. I can probably edit it out. Okay, now. Secret coming up here shortly. Now there's a way to solve this puzzle normally. Open the door, got clear buttons in spike pits, so the idea is you stick the ball in the spikes and jump in and press the clear button. But I'm not going to do that. We look into this one. Spikes go much deeper than in the other two. And we go! That's a secret. Yeah, the slowly turning stone head. It's very like, goes very well with the music, I find. I don't know. Amimitl, even. Many citizens have gone to the Stargazer, speaking of ill omens and waking dreams. They speak of a secret in the forbidden place, a great mysterious power, trespass is a sin graver than 1,000 deaths. They gave us the gift, and they can take it away. Still, the people speak. Want and desire will decide. People will ask questions, and once asked... People will ask questions. Yeah, I know. Want and desire will decide. That's the door opening. The door opened just because now I can't go back and use the ball to solve that puzzle normally. If I had done that, I know because I did it on my last playthrough, I think. If I had solved the puzzle normally using the ball, then this trigger would have closed the door again and I'd have been stuck. I think. Something like that. Anyway, so let's continue down this little corridor. Yeah, this is a dead end, I think. And we continue up this way. Yes, there's another secret, but I want to explore this place fully as well. Oh, what's in here? Dead end. And, oh look! An ad for Aurence's Short de Jong, the main man in this project. So, this is obviously non-canon, or is it? You know, maybe there's a Short de Jong in ancient Mesoamerica in this alternative universe. They brought the ball. We don't see it powering any video screens or anything like that. We just see it powering machinery. But sure, you never know. Maybe the aliens recorded all the video screens once they retreated from the humans, and you know maybe there was a guy down here developing video games before everything went west, everything went south. I don't know what the expression is, but yeah, maybe Orange has existed in this universe as a Mesoamerican game developer working with the ball's technology. Anyway, that's a different kind of secret. But, shoot. Now, this is the next secret. Tlaltecuhtli. The son of Quetzalcoatl, once a chieftain, and now the ruler of all that lays under the banner of fire, has written a new law. The gods speak through me, he proclaimed. My will is as theirs. No man, woman, or child shall step foot into the forbidden place. The gift was given, and so it can be taken. We will praise with bloodletting on the next whole moon. Yeah? So... things continuing on. So he's trying to keep the lesser peoples away from the gift, but like, that's not gonna work. And again, yeah, it's humans, the imperialism, the supposition that some race is superior to others, yeah, led to the downfall of this place. At least that's my interpretation. Yeah, it was at one point, but no more about that. So I have to get the ball here. Now how on earth do I get to the ball, since I left it somewhere and then went underground and emerged in a different place? And look, mummies, oh dear, oh my god. But Well, we just have to go back and find the door that was opened, even though I didn't solve the puzzle properly. Secret opened. Oh no, I went the wrong way. Ah, for God's sake. Ah, and that triggers the combat music. Here you are. You see, last time I played through it, I solved the puzzle normally before getting the secret, and so this door was closed when I came back here. So I had no choice but to die to come back and get the ball. So yeah, that's a glitch. Slightly, but there's more puzzles to be solved before it comes down completely. Oh joy. Okay, the combat has stopped. The area complete jingle stopped it. Okay. Symbols, graffiti. This is the way out, is it? Oh no, it's the next puzzle. Well, not the next puzzle, you can do them in any order you want. So here. First thing you have to do is flood the chamber, unless you want the mummies to keep killing you. I remember that was kind of frustrating in my first playthrough until I figured that out. And there's this place. A lot going on in there. Platform over here and jump on it. No, I can't jump on it. What we can do is flood the chamber again. Platform starts floating up, but luckily we can sort of glide onto it, or we should be able to. Yes, we're in here. Excellent. Except if I go back down, discover I should have brought the ball, isn't that it? need to connect the ball to this in order to proceed. So I need to defloat the chamber again because the ball was supposed to be on that platform. Come on, ball. No. Okay, gotta go around the other way. No big deal. No. No. Hey. No. No. Oh, physics. Because it doesn't really matter what happens to it. Can't be pulled through water. Because it's so heavy. Now, I next need to get to that clear button. Which is easy because the whole chamber is flooded. And I'm pretty sure there's no secret around here because I know where we've already got three secrets and I know where the fourth one is. And this clear button is pushed down another little bit. But the chamber remains flooded because there's no way to deflood it after what happened there. But, I'm gonna drown. Ball. Yeah, see, I should have brought it back to the main chamber to save myself some time here. And now I'm drowning. Come on, Dad. First time we see a cube button that isn't recessed into the wall. If you're looking at it from over here, no, back here, you can't tell it's a cube. It looks like a ball button. So, clearly can't bring the ball in here. There's even an invisible wall. Never mind the fact that the door's too narrow. So what the hell do you think you're doing? My first few playthroughs, I had no idea what to do here. I had to bring up the hint, which of course spoil the whole puzzle, as things tend to do. But yeah, this is a cube button. Oh, and as for the cubes, they're back here. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Gotcha.
And that's just that platform moving. Then we need, and then there's another cube down here. So awkward. This player button is down. Oh, it sends ripples through the water and everything. Nice touch. Okay, let's keep going. More mummies, that's good. So weird. The flashing light, I mean. No, there's a cube button recessed in a wall. I know exactly what you're doing. There we go. Small back here. Let's go down this path. And it doesn't quite go far enough. Let's try it again. And look, we're cut off from our ball. Lovely. Okay, so that opens this door. Tricky platforming. With rising lava to boot. Is it rising or my mind playing tricks at me? Not that difficult really. Okay. How did you get here? Of geometry see and create around here. The place with the bombs. Yeah. Oztoc I was where we first saw the bombs. But until I visited that alternative path, I didn't think we actually interacted with them there. We just lit a fuse for one, set off another one. Anyway, I'll get to interact with bombs in this part. But first of all, let's see what's happening in here. I guess. Nahual? There's no G in Nahuatl. The language, I mean. There's no G in that language, I would have thought. So, Nahual. Nahual? I don't know. Anyway, I'm forbidden to scribe, for I'm a slave. Yet I speak. The masters work this night and day in the mechanical labor palace. There is no sky for us. Only the fires from the world light our grievances. The air is dank with ash and poisonous to our bodies. The soil is hard and cuts at our flesh. Those who die are rolled down the fiery shores and replaced. Yeah. Forbidden to scribe. So yeah, we know these secrets. They're not written, they're spoken. It's just one of the many weirdnesses. So yeah. I guess the idea is the ball comes down here and it reanimates the mummies and it reanimates the spirits of the people inside these stone heads. Now I don't know why they're in the stone heads, but they're there. So it reanimates the true spirits of just a few select people. However many secrets there are in the game, but most people, it reanimates the mummies and they're just mindless zombies trying to kill us. But the ball itself seems to be protecting us because so much stuff is saved when we die. We just come back. We seem to be kind of undead ourselves. Yeah, I'm gonna dispatch those bombs with the ball. What exactly am I doing here? That's a funny looking symbol. There's a guy. Thank you. 1.
That's not fair.
Now I'm all the way back here. Oh, where's my ball? Sorry, I keep pointing at the screen and then you can't actually see me pointing. So that is an artificial sun. That is the eternal moon that the music refers to, I guess. Right, so that's pretty much that, is it? So yeah, more about the slaves, notions of slaves getting restless, rebelling, perhaps. Well, not quite yet, but you can feel it in the air almost. And obviously the plague means that something terrible happened. But the secrets aren't telling us exactly what yet. But yeah, this was a good video, I think. I hope. You agree with me, and see you next time.